Welcome everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about what is a columnar database. So we are going to discuss about the various terminologies which is getting involved in designing the columnar databases and what are all the advantages which we are going to achieve by using these columnar databases typically in the data analytics field. What the columnar databases is all about? We know this gramophone and we know this gramophone disc. What is the analogy? What is the connection? So it is like the gramophone head which revolves around this disc, so that it will take the inputs from this disc and it will convert it into sound, and then we will hear this sound over there. So this working analogy is more or less similar to the way in which the data is written. So taking the same gramophone disc, this is how our hard disks are. So the data is getting written in these disks in the similar fashion. So let's take the same analogy, let's take the same table, and I am firing a query. It is something different. It is not the select star query. I am going to do select sum of sales from this table name, which means I need to take these three columns, I need to sum it up, and then I need to get the final output, which is going to be sum of all these three fields. This is a typical analytics query. This is how the analytics works actually. As we already discussed, data aggregations needs to happen. So let's take a traditional data row sequence. Let's take it as an oracle. So in the oracle, if you can take, the data is stored in this way. It is like it is stored in this way in this disk. So the pointer or the header, what it does, say it must have to, it will come to India, it will come to cricket bat, and then it will take this 10,000. On the third read it will take this, then fourth read is Australia, fifth read is cricket ball, and on the sixth read it will pick that 2000. Say similar way it happens on the ninth read, it will pick that 5000, then it will aggregate all these three together. So the number of IO reads which it take for this operation to complete is 9, which means it is going through each and everything in a sequential way and taking the required column and summing it up. But when it comes to a columnar sequence, where we will be storing the data in a columnar way. In this way, if we can see, India, Australia and Sri Lanka are stored in an one row, and cricket bat, cricket ball, and again cricket bat is stored in the another row, and then finally if you can see, the 10,000, 2,000 and 5,000 will be stored in the another row. So if I fire this query, typical analytics query, against this data which is stored in a columnar way, there is no necessity for me to scan across these two rows. I can simply scan the third row, which will be only 3 IO operations for me. I will take that data and I will simply do the aggregate and I will return it back to you. So for a typical analytics process, for a typical data aggregation process, storing the data in a columnar way is much more efficient compared to traditional row wise storage. So columnar is getting more traction nowadays. Typical data warehousing stuff, whoever the modern data warehousing, everywhere we are making use of the columnar only. So what are all the advantages which I am going to have as the part of this approach? It is like, as we already discussed, we are going to query only on the few columns, not on all the columns actually. So data aggregation is going to be very, very simple. It provides lot of compression as well. Since we are aggregating the data based on the data types, we can compress the data. So this will provide me lot of TCO. It is like it will lower my total cost of ownership. The cost which is spent in storing the data is also reduced. So columnar is one very important thing which we need to know as the part of the modern data warehousing. So I hope this session has been informative for you. If you like this session, you please do comment, do like and do subscribe for my YouTube channel. This will help me to improvise my contents, and also this will help me to create more videos in a similar fashion. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.